Thank you all.
Jabbour, and with me is Stephen Wade, my wonderful sidekick. We love playing together but don't do it enough, and playing a concert here at the library gave us a great excuse to play more together with each other, and it's been a pleasure. Stephen, by the way, is not only a banjo player but a researcher, and has produced, I've got to brag for him here, he's produced a record called A Treasury of Library of Congress Field Recordings, which just happens to be out in the shop out there. There's even a couple of records of him as well out in the shop. And he's a wonderful part of the library. He doesn't work at the library, but in a way he's a part of the Library of Congress family. He spends a lot of time here. He's drawn from the archive. He expands the archive with the work he does, visiting musicians around the country. So it's a pleasure to have him with us today. There's the record. And that tune we just played.
Thank you.
Oh. That tune we just played is a tune called Stony Point. It actually has a bunch of names, and it's an old fiddle tune in America. When I first started researching fiddle tunes, I thought, oh, I'll bet I trace this back to the British Isles. Now, some tunes do trace back to the British Isles, but in fact, though, it is in every part of the United States under a variety of names. And though it's very old, it goes back at least to the beginning of the 19th century, or maybe the late 18th century, it's never been actually recorded outside of the United States. So it's clearly, I think, an American fiddle tune. Stony Point probably refers to the fact that there was a famous battle during the Revolutionary War, the Battle of Stony Point, where Mad Anthony Wayne and his Pennsylvania Scotch-Irish snuck up on and assaulted the British in a stronghold up along the Hudson. And this tune, I like to imagine, and this name at least, commemorates that. There's other tunes named Stony Point too, but one function of fiddle tunes, obviously, is commemorating important events in history, especially in an oral culture. You don't commemorate it by writing a book about it, you commemorate it by naming a fiddle tune for it. So there's Stony Point. I learned it from a fiddler named Henry Reed, who was in his 80s, in the 1960s, when I was a young kid hanging out with him. And he he taught me Stony Point the way I play it. And I learned this next tune as well from him. It's a tune that he calls Shoes and Stockings. And Henry Reed learned it from, he says, now I learned this from old man Quince Dillion. And I said, old man Quince Dillion? He says, yes, he was 90 when I was a kid. And he says, I can remember him playing, and he was so drunk that the saliva was dripping out of the side of his mouth down onto the fiddle when he, this made a lasting impression on the kid. Quince Dillion was born in 1810. He was a fifer in the Mexican War. And, you know, people talk about fiddle tunes being passed along from generation to generation. It's actually even more interesting than that, because very often a fiddle tune is passed from an old man to a kid. And so Quince Dillion passed it to Henry Reed. Henry Reed is an old man, passed it to me. So there's only one person between me and this fiddler and fifer, this product of Jacksonian democracy in America, fifed in the Civil War, in the Mexican War. He would have been too old to fight in the Civil War. And one person between him and me. It's sort of awesome to think about. Here's Shoes and Stockings.